So if you're considering using furosemide on exercise-induced pulmonary hemorrhage in horses, or EIPH, it's important to understand the mechanism of furosemide as well as the pathogenesis of EIPH. Furosemide is a sulfonamide antidiuretic that expels the body's water by preventing the reabsorption of sodium and chloride, and if given in excess amounts, it can lead to expelling of potassium as well. It does this by binding to the sodium potassium chloride cotransporters on the thick ascending loop of Henle, which is on a nephron within the kidney, and also has hemodynamic effects that assist with urinating, such as vasodilation to allow more blood to filter through, and renal dilation by prostaglandin synthesis, which allows more blood to come in and create more urine. Doing this reduces total blood volume as well as cardiac output, which can lead to decreased secretions in the respiratory tract, which then leads to disease. Now, exercise-induced pulmonary hemorrhage is bleeding within the lungs following intense exercise and is most often seen in thoroughbred or standardbred horses. And the cause is really unknown as to how it happens. You can know if your horse has this by doing a tracheobronchoscopic examination, bronchoalveolar lavage. You see epistaxis or the horse is coughing. So what you need to know is that there is very low to low evidence that there are race time differences between horses with EIPH and those without EIPH, that there is no association or there's no evidence that lactic acid concentrations are a cause of EIPH, that it interferes with oxygen transfer within the lungs, that it causes a disease, is the cause of a disease, that there are radiographic imagings or proof of this, or that it's a genetic predisposition to this disease. What evidence that there is available is that horses with EIPH have lesions in the lungs, and that those that have been diagnosed with EIPH from a grade 2 to 4 earn less money, and that horses without EIPH have greater placement within races. So, because of all the different mechanisms or theories of how EIPH happens, furosemide is used in theory to decrease pulmonary arterial and wedge pressures, which then leads to a decrease in pulmonary capillary and transmural pressures during intense exercise. And because it's used prior to intense exercise, it's considered a prophylactic rather than a treatment. And there is evidence that furosemide does help horses diagnosed with EIPH, that in any horse, it increases the horse's speed, decreases energy costs, and is beneficial to male horses. However, the studies of these coming from systematic reviews or articles have noise due to the low numbers of horses being tested. And there is also misclassification bias of some veterinarians being able to report cases better than others. So, I would not recommend furosemide if your horse has kidney disease or isn't eating or has a poor appetite, because it can lead to hypokalemia and hyponatremia. I would recommend it for athletic horses especially, that have been diagnosed with exercise-induced pulmonary hemorrhage.